Do you know how you can build up your career in esport? Today, I'll talk about how I build up my career in esport. So let's get right into it. Welcome back. My name is Jasper. And today we are going to get straight into how I build up a career through esport. And how you can do the same. So, when we want to build up our career, it all comes down to how competent you are and the results. And we have to understand that the results comes when you are competent. And the results show how competent you are and what is your competencies. Because especially like in esport, you have a lot of entrepreneur people and so on. So you have started in the last couple of years getting a lot of more corporate and structure in, which is very needed. But it's like people don't care if you come and say, I have done social media at this grassroots esports organizations that nobody knows of. Nobody will give a shit. Like, nobody cares. It doesn't matter to anyone. Yeah. And it doesn't tell anything. Okay. Like, everyone could have done it. But if you can come to some company and say, I work at this as a volunteer at this grassroots esports organization where we had 200 followers on Facebook, and I grew their social media with 1.5x the reach and got it up to 2,000 Facebook followers in 6 months. Some people will more be like, okay, this person can, like, got something, like this person can do something, you know about something, like you did it, and then you can go more into details like, how did you actually do it? So it can be, I focus most of my time on community engagement. So I make sure we had images for match days, just interacting with people, making memes, making people to engage with our post, and so on and so forth. Like, however you might have done it to get to that point. And then you can also, in that, like, be honest and add more to it. Like, yeah, so I had to learn to do this. And I learned how to use Photoshop or maybe something else. And I use like these platforms, and it shows for the company that you are maybe applying for a job at, that okay, this person has delivered results, which means they have some level of skills. You have some level of skills, and you also you have some level of curiosity that you are actually able to go out and find new information and obtain new knowledge and skills that can help you in your work. So the way I did it, I started as a volunteer, and I just started applying for, like, how can I just try to figure out, like, how could I be part of esports events, and maybe be a coach in CSGO, which I also was. And I actually signed up as a volunteer for an event, and they needed some tournament operators, so I was just, hey, I can help with that. I didn't know what I was signing up for, but then I ended up working with tournaments, and they want, hey, if you want to work more with tournaments, then you can join us in a local like tournament organizer. So I just started. So just to also clarify everything, I was just in a period of time where I just tried a bunch of stuff. So everything is kind of spread out of what I have done. So I try everything, social media, strategic planning, organizing, planning events, and customer service, and so on and so forth. But I started as a tournament operator and was just kind of willing to help. So always, hey, can I help with something? When they ask, hey, can you help with this? Yeah, let me try it. Then I try it out, try things out, and then you just start building more and more. And especially like with those that are above you, like the more you can help them, the more you can also get into like these positions when they either are moving on or they are going or into another position. Because then you're already kind of qualified, because you already know what they were doing, how it should be done. So it helps you a lot to get into higher positions, which you then can leverage later on. But then I got more and more responsibility. As I said, was part of developing tournaments, gathering feedbacks, planning tournaments, and I ended actually up being the general manager for the whole organization. And yeah, and then I started doing fuck. So I ended up being the general manager for the whole organization, and that meant I was able to start a lot of projects, really work and dive into things, because I was the one who could make the decision. So what I did was that I was starting a few different projects. So for example, build a seating system in a spreadsheet that where I had to find information, and I had to then I had to set it up. But at the end of the day, it helped us reduce like the time we spend on seeding and placing teams with like 4 hours or so, which was a really good project. And especially like when you're applying, it's a good project that you can kind of explain for when it fits in, of course. But another project I did, and to give the background, then at the same time I was a volunteer, I was studying on the side, so I have a education in service, in hospitality, tourism, and service management, with a specialization in sport and event management. And then I took a bachelor degree in sports management. So as part of my education, or my hospitality, tourism and service management education, I had an internship where I was at DreamHack Sports Games. So they are making TV products out of esports titles, specifically in the sport games. So I was observing a lot, like, okay, how are they how they're planning it, how they're playing the tournaments, how they're playing the whole broadcast. And I could see like they're playing a lot in details from what each person are doing. So it is called a rundown that just describe like like here at 20 minutes in, you're doing this, then you this person do that. All the way, like complete detail out. And when they're kind of working on the tournaments, they was thinking a lot about like, okay, when we have the regular season, the group stages, then we have go into the playoffs. How do we create the storyline to go into the playoffs? How do we create the storyline for players to into finals? And how does it mess throughout the whole tournament? How many days do we have? And so on and so forth. So I was taking all these observations back and I started rebuilding our whole broadcast production. So I had to make all the rundowns, playing it real simple. Okay, what should people do for each day, for the regular season, for playoffs, and for the finals? And how do we make it visible that you can see, okay, this is the regular season, this is the playoffs, this is the final. So how can you see that in the broadcast? If you don't read the text, which information do we need to give people in the graphics? Like what should be in the title? Because we use Twitch. And all these things had to correlate and make sense together. So when everything was kind of done in the idea, we had to set everything up like and form out like, okay, we need the graphic to look like this, we need these logos in that many, we have to show this. And I went out to find a graphic designer who surprisingly could do it all for free. I still don't understand it, but it was one of my biggest projects because I also had to both learn how to use Photoshop and a deep better understanding OBS, which is a broadcast software for those who don't know. So all this I had to understand and just streamline all the systems and processes over time and continuously work with people. Like that was the hardest part, that I had to make all the other volunteers to understand that when we press live, when we go live, you gotta be fucking ready. We gotta be on point. If one of us fuck up, everyone can fucking see it. And it happens multiple times. And that's where really I had to develop kind of leader skills in terms of the mentoring part. Like how do you influence people and mold them in the right way to understand like we need to do it like this. So that was a huge learning experience for me, and that's actually one of the projects that I use very often when I had to apply for jobs, because there are so many parts of it that you could use in all kinds of different scenarios that you can work into multiple things. And it's also a thing that like most people are quite surprised of. And like especially for me, like over time when you start having a few projects where you're like, yeah, I did this, 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 and this, like you just have four. And maybe one of them has a good size to it. Then people start, okay, you definitely can do something here. To kind of quickly sum up and let us continue, is that through the volunteer job, yeah, you might not be able to like to do that much in the beginning, because you have to work there a long time and kind of get up in the ranks, where the kind of title of the position means a bit more, and you have a bit more to say, where you really can start doing projects and really incorporating knowledge from your education if you're doing exact same as me. But one thing I really focused on was that I was building up my skills through this volunteer work, and then I knew, like, in the degrees I chose, that they all have internships, so that will give me the opportunity to get into a position where I could actually get a job after the internship. And then you also have to be a little bit strategic about choosing the internship, because you want to choose a company where you are actually, where they're actually able to hire you afterwards. And it's like, but you also want to choose a company where it's like, you are able to do a lot and try things out, where you don't just get into this like fixed role that do this, boom, boom, this is how you do it, boom, boom, boom. Where it's like, you don't got that much freedom, if you can say so, to try out your, what you're learning and stuff like that. But you can still do it. Like, at least, you want at least to find a place where they can hire you afterwards. Because then you can go in and you have built up the skills. So you go in a position that matches as best as possible what you're doing in a volunteer job. And then you are actually able to crush it. And instead of you have a CV that where it doesn't look, it does look like helps a bit that you have the experience, but it's like, what don't help you that much is like, it's most likely some grassroots organization you are working at that nobody fucking knows about. So that you are actually having, can have an internship and just go in and show like, this is how fucking good I'm at, good I am, and you can take it. And that was what I did. So I had, as I said, there are two internships. So the first one, I actually went in, it went well, the corona hit, awesome. But the end of the day, they wanted me to continue, but unfortunately, they didn't have management changes, so my foot in the door got caught off. Okay, that sounds weird, but yeah, I got quickly out of the law as the management also changed, because that person I had my contact with got kicked out. Yeah, they got changed. Yeah, I don't know exactly what happened, but a fun story like from that internship was that my contact person actually came over like completely cool, like staying there. It's a bit irritating that you don't make any mistakes. And I was just saying, what are we talking about? I make plenty of mistakes. I just fixing them before people can even see them. And that's something like, actually by you developing your skills in a volunteer way, you can cut down on a lot of the mistakes you're making. And I can tell you, I make probably 90% of everything I do is failing and fucking up. So the last 10% is all the good things you see. Like, for example, with the broadcast production build up, like getting people to understand that you don't just press start. It took me, how long this, like 6 months for them to understand, really start, okay, fuck, we just don't press start. Then it took 2 months more to see, okay, now it starts to work. Now things start to rolling smooth. And then was that in six, eight months more, then we hit 3 finals back to back to back, just run perfectly. So then in between all these months, then you can just start thinking about like how many times I have just seen fuck ups in the broadcast and had to figure out like how can I tell them we need to do it this way, we need to do it that way. Go in and fix the system and process, understand like why did this fail when you had to transition? Didn't you have enough time? Figure out like how can we change things up, and so on and so forth. So it took 1.5 years to make it fucking perfectly. There's 2 kind of ways you can do it, and one is most likely you will have to find a volunteer job, because you can't really expect to get paid for the things you do in the beginning, and you kind of have to. Yeah, you have to develop the skills, but also all the money is in the top, so it's can kind of be a little bit hard. And what you can hope for is you maybe can find an esports related student worker job where you actually can get paid for it, and then potentially devote even more time into it that you actually are able to create a living while you're studying. But a completely like other way is that you can actually just start working your way up in other industries, maybe in the sport industry. You can do this too, but you can actually just start working your way up, because esports is actually lacking a lot of structure and an organization. So getting into all these really already functioning industries before you jump into esports can be beneficial, because you kind of get a better understanding of like how things actually runs in a more professionalized and structural way, which you can take into esports. And that's actually what you are seeing, like with all the different types of investors they're bringing in, CEOs, C-level position people. You have, for example, in Astralis, you have Kasper Witt as the sports director, who was the Danish handball goalkeeper on the national team. So he had a lot of, like, he had all his sports experience with, in terms of performance, recovery, and all that he could take in and start making it more professional in the way the whole team was structured and everything. So that's the way you can do it. So it was a longer video today. If you come to the end, please let me know in the comment section below how you will start your esports career. And if you like the video, please hit the thumbs up. If you want to see more, please hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you next time on Jasper. I'm out. Peace.